Can we begin?
Yes, we can start. 古鲁玛尼，你开始开场白好了。
好好的，拜昆塔金，服务员莅临，各位尊敬的 Vaishnava 奉献者，早上好。今天是2021年6月1日，我们又荣幸的邀请到了圣 Bhakti Vipna Vinash Narasimha Swami Maharaj 为我们讲解今天的大国家瓦坛早课，敬请聆听。
Hare Krishna. Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste.Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatarine Vanchakaupatarupyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha.Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.So we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. We're in the second half of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, describing the travel of Gop Kumar, who was a cowherd boy from Govardhan. So Gop Kumar was giving teaching. He met this one Brahmana from Mathura, and he was explaining to him about his travels, how he traveled by the power of a mantra, and he was able to travel everywhere.
He met a Mathura from Mathura. He explained to this Mathura his travels.
And Gop Kumar described how he'd gone to the spiritual world and he met with Krishna in the spiritual world, and Krishna told him that he's actually a cowherd boy and his name is Sarupa. He
traveled to the spiritual world.在灵性世界他遇见了主 Krishna， Krishna 呢就告诉他，实际上他真实的名字呢，他是一位牧牛童，他的名字叫 Sarupa。
So Sarupa told everything about his travel to the in the material and in the spiritual world to this Brahmana.
Sarupa 就向这位婆罗门就讲述了他在物质世界以及又在灵性世界旅行的种种的经历。
So after Sarupa had told the Brahmana everything, then he asked the Brahmana, he said, now you have to decide for yourself what is the highest goal of life.
然后在 Sarupa 向这位婆罗门解释完一切之后，他就对这位婆罗门说道，现在你自己来决定什么是生命的最高目标。
And how are you going to, if you know what the goal of life is, the highest goal of life is, how are you going to achieve it?
既然你已经 知道了生命的最高最崇高的目标是什么，然后你就要了解该如何达到这样的目标。
So Sarupa had been describing about Goloka and the special nature of Goloka and how devotees there enjoy a loving relationship with Lord Krishna.
Sarupa 描述了 Goloka 的本质，以及在 Goloka 那里的奉献者是如何跟主 Krishna 一起共度时光的。
When the Brahmana first met Gop Kumar, he had said to him, he said, I've heard about many different goals and many different ways in which to achieve these goals, but I can't decide what I should do.
这位婆罗门就对 Sarupa 坦白说，在遇到你之前呢，我了解了有不同的生命目标，以及有各种不同的方法，而且呢，我是无所适从。
So Sarupa had been Sarupa, that who's, you know, Sarupa is the name of the Gop Kumar. Sarupa asked the Brahmana, "What is his opinion now? Because he's heard everything. He's told him everything." So he's told him about Goloka. So he asked the Brahmana. So he said, "What do you think you should do to get the goal?" To achieve the goal.
那现在这位就是叫 Sarupa， Sarupa 呢就问这位婆罗门，既然现在你已经聆听了一切，我已经把一切都对你和盘托出了，你也知道了了解了有关于 Goloka， 那么然后 Sarupa 就问这位婆罗门，那么接下来。你为了达到这样的目标，你打算怎么做呢？
You can see, just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna spoke to Arjuna. Arjuna had asked Krishna to instruct him, and Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna, and then at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says to Arjuna, "Now you decide, what are you going to do?"
就像在国家梵歌当中，如 Krishna 对 Arjuna 给予 Arjuna 教导， Arjuna 从 Krishna 那里得到了训示，在结尾的时候，如 Krishna 就对 Arjuna 说，现在由你自己来决定你接下来该怎么做。
So Sarupa says to the Brahmana, he said, actually you've already achieved your goal by the mercy of the divine goddess.
Sarupa 就对这个婆罗门说，实际上你已经达到了你的你由于神圣的女神的仁慈，你已经达到了目标了。
Actually, the Brahmana has still to, he's not yet realized the glories of Goloka directly.
实际上，这位婆罗门还没有直接的、第一手经验的觉悟到 Goloka 的荣耀。
But Sarupa is not going to tell him anymore. He's telling him, "You just be patient, and you will see everything with your own eyes."
但是 Sarupa 对这位婆罗门，他不打算再给他讲述更多的内容。他就告诉这婆罗门要耐心，然后他就会自己亲眼见证了一切。
Yeah, you. There's something left for you to do. For you, is still some things for you to achieve, but you're very close. It won't be long before you achieve everything.
他就对这婆罗门说，接下来还有一些工作要由你自己亲自去做，你要达到这个目标， 你已经接近了这个目标了，而且很快不久你就会实现你的目标。
Krishna has given you his full mercy.
Krishna 已经把全部的仁慈都赐予了你。
Because the Brahmana may say, you know, I haven't got any, there's no signs of perfection appeared in me yet. The Brahmana is humble, he will say, I'm not yet perfect.
这婆罗门可能会说，在我身上还没有达到完美的迹象啊，因为这个婆罗门非常谦卑。
But Sarupa doesn't agree. He can see that Krishna has already given him a lot, full mercy.
But Sarupa 不同意他的这番话。他说 他看到 Krishna 呢已经完美的把他的仁慈都赐予了这位婆罗门。
And Sarupa said, I've told you everything that happened to me and everything that happened to Krishna and his devotees, and these things are very confidential.
Sarupa 说，我已经把我自己的一切都向你讲述了，我已经给你讲述了关于 Krishna 的方方面面，而且这些话题是至为机密的。
Because Sarupa had been telling him about some of the special ecstasies which devotees experience in the shelter of Krishna's lotus feet.
因为 Sarupa 已经向这婆罗门讲述了奉献者感受到的狂喜之情。奉献者们，他们都脱离了 Krishna 的莲花足了。
Yeah, one shouldn't want to reveal these things to people.
人们不应该一个人不应当向别人来揭示这些机密的话题。
We shouldn't even want to think about them in our mind.
我们甚至连想都不应该想。
But sometimes the devotee, they'll reach special consciousness where they cannot even recognize themselves. They can't distinguish themselves. They can't recognize themselves or others. They can't distinguish one thing from another.
但有的时候奉献者们他们就在狂喜当中他们是没办法分辨区分就是他们已经浑然忘我了。
But Sarupa says somehow Krishna entered my heart and he got me to speak about these things to you. Usually I won't speak to anybody about these things, but somehow Krishna got me to tell you all about them.
但是无论如何 ，Krishna 他进入了 ，Sarupa 说 Krishna 进入了他的内心。然后就促使他，把他内心的这些都向这位婆罗门讲述了。而且一般来说，这个话题是不应该向别人透露的。
Before the Brahmana had met Gop Kumar, before the Brahmana had met with the Sarupa, he was just a neophyte. He didn't know anything.
在这婆罗门遇见 Sarupa 之前，他只是一位初习者，他是一无所知的。
And Sarupa sometimes he would be in ecstasy, you know, because he had so much love for Krishna. Sometimes he would be experiencing ecstasies, and so it was difficult for him to instruct the Brahmana.
但是 Sarupa。他处在狂喜当中，他内心充盈着对 Krishna 的爱，他在体验着这一切的感受，所以对他来说，对别人讲话就是很难的一件事。
But because Krishna's in the heart, Krishna somehow forced the story, got Sarupa to tell everything which was happening.
Krishna 就在他的内心，所以主 Krishna 强迫他就对这位婆罗门讲了一切。
So this a spiritual master will reveal everything to the faithful disciple.
一位灵性导师，他会向忠诚的门徒揭示一切。
So Sarupa says to the Brahmana, I can see that you have strong faith, you have great faith in these things, and that faith will bring rewards to you.
Sarupa 对这位婆罗门说，我看得出你拥有强烈的信心，而这份强烈的信心会给你巨大的回报。
So somebody who is advanced, they can understand the position of other people.
一位进步的人，他就能明白别人的一切。
So Sarupa could see from the face of the Brahmana that this Brahmana is very qualified. He's a good devotee. He has great faith.
Sarupa 就从这位婆罗门的脸上的表情就能看出他是一位极具资格的优秀奉献者。
So when there's strong faith, then the spiritual practice will give.Quickly will give fruit.
倘若一个人拥有强烈的信心的话，那么他的灵修就能给他很快给他带来灵修的结果。
And Sarupa says, he said, just this morning, early this morning, Sri Radhika, Srimati Radharani herself came and ordered me.That I should come to you and teach you.
Sarupa 就说，实际上就在今天早晨，Srimati Radharani Sri Radhika 自己就亲自来到我这里，命令我来找你，教导你这一切。
So this Mathura Brahmana, he's actually a devotee.He was actually a devotee of Durga, but Durga is a partial expansion of Radharani.
这位 Mathura 的婆罗门实际上是 Durga 女神的奉献者，但是 Durga 女神是Srimati Radharani 的部分扩展。
So Srimati Radharani came to Sarupa and told him that you go there alone and.Enlighten that Brahmana, give him good instruction.
Sri Radhika 就来到 Sarupa 面前，对他说：“你独自一个人去启迪那位婆罗门，给予他训示。”
And help him to get the mercy of Lord Krishna.
你帮助他获得主 Krishna 的仁慈。
If the Sarupa had not come to the Brahmana would not get Krishna's mercy.
倘若 Sarupa 没有来找这位 Brahmana 的话，这位 Brahmana 是无法获得 Krishna 的仁慈的。
So Sarupa said, when she instructed me like that, I came here immediately without thinking anything else. I just came here to teach you.
Srimati Radharani 这样给我训示的时候，我不加思索的我就直接来到这里来教导你。
I didn't even think about that I'm going to have to miss association with Krishna. I just came here to instruct you.
我甚至都不考虑自己会不会思念与 Krishna 的联谊，我会不会想念 Krishna。 我就直接径直来到这里来给你训示。
Sarupa said, I left early in the morning, even before Krishna went to the forest with the other cowherd boys.
甚至在主 Krishna 和其他的牧牛童离开家去森林之前，我就一大早早的在清晨来临之前，我就来到这里了。
I didn't worry about leaving Krishna's company because I knew it's more important to carry out the order of Radharani.
我甚至都不去担心，我是不是要离开 Krishna 的陪伴，因为执行 Radharani 的训示是更重要的一件事儿。
And that would, Lord Krishna would be pleased that I followed the order of Radharani.
我执行 Radharani 的命令，是更能取悦主 Krishna。
And this way I'll be even more happier. I'll enjoy more pleasure in the company with Lord Krishna.
这样，当我在和主 Krishna与他为伴的时候，我内心就会更加快乐了。
So Sarupa saw that the Brahmana had still not awakened pure love. So Sarupa put his hand on the Brahmana's head.
Sarupa 看出这位 Brahmana 还没有唤醒纯粹的爱，他就把手放在这位 Brahmana 的头上。
And when he put his hand on the head of that Brahmana, then the mercy of that great soul, Sarupa, then the Brahmana's heart, it awakened. He awakened love for Krishna.
当这位伟大的灵魂以这种方式把他的仁慈灌注到这位 Brahmana 的内心时，这位 Brahmana 就内心唤醒了对 Krishna 的爱。
Just everything that Sarupa experienced, it was revealed to the Brahmana.
Sarupa 他所体验到的一切，就在这位 Brahmana 的内心得以揭示出来。
So the Brahmana, he could immediately achieve perfection, and he could understand his spiritual identity.
这位 Brahmana 立即就达到了完美，明白到自己的灵性身份。
So this is the power of meeting with a great devotee.
这就是遇见一位伟大奉献者的力量所在。
Usually, only Krishna's most qualified devotees get love of God after a long time.
一般而言，只有 Krishna 最有资格的奉献者，经历了很长的时间之后，才能获得神爱。
So how could this Brahmana get Krishna prem so quickly?
这位 Brahmana 又是如何以这样迅速的就获得的 Krishna 的爱呢？ Krishna prem.
So this was due just simply due to his contact with a powerful devotee.
原因就在于他与一位强有力的奉献者的联系。
If the Brahmana had tried on his own, he would never have been successful.
倘若这位 Brahmana是靠自己的力量去努力的话，他是不会取得这样的成功的。
It's only by that special association with a great devotee.
原因只是由于和一位伟大奉献者的特殊的联谊。
Just like Devahuti says in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Devahuti talking to Lord Kapila, her son, and she's saying that to associate with material objects is the path of bondage.
就像 Devahuti 在圣典博加瓦坛当中对他的儿子 Kapila 所说的，他说和物质对象的联谊只会和物质对象的联谊是受束缚的道路。
But if I can get association with a devotee, a saintly person, then that's the path of liberation.
倘若我和一位奉献者、一位圣人联谊，那将是获得解脱的道路。
Even if I don't have any knowledge, still I can get that liberation by association with a great devotee.
即便我自己没有知识，我也能通过与这样一位伟大奉献者的联谊达到解脱。
Yeah. We reflect the company we associate with. If we associate with drunkards, we'll become a drunkard.
我们反射出我们自己的联谊对象，倘若和醉汉联谊，我们自己也能变成一位醉汉。
But if we associate with pure souls, with great devotees, then we'll become like them. We'll also become detached from matter and we'll develop a love for Krishna.
倘若我们和一位纯粹的灵魂，一位伟大的奉献者联谊，我们也能像他们一样发展出对物质的弃绝之心，并且发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
To develop prema, this is to develop love for Krishna means we have to become detached from all material situations.
发展出对 Krishna 的爱 ，Krishna prema， 就意味着我们必须要弃绝一切物质的处境。
We only want to please Krishna, nothing else.
我们是只想取悦。Krishna, 除此之外，我们不会去讨好任何人。
So in every situation, we should want to approach an advanced devotee, a sadhu, and we should, even if we don't get any teachings from them, still we should want to be near them.
因此，在一切处境之下，我们应当想方设法接近一位进步的奉献者，一位沙度。即便我们，即便是他没有说话，我们也应当离他很近。
That even if we can just have some little talk, chit chat with them, that can be so valuable.
即便是跟他只是这样。稀疏平常的，闲聊几句，也会有巨大的价值。
In their association, what seems like disaster becomes great mercy.
就是在跟这样的奉献者、伟大灵魂的联谊之下，即便是巨大的灾难，也能看起来就像是仁慈。
And what seems like death becomes like nectar.
而表面上好像是死亡也能看起来就有如甘露一般。
And serving the lotus feet of the spiritual master, we can develop ecstasy and love of God.
在对灵性导师的莲花族的服务当中。我们能发展起对 Krishna 的狂喜的爱。
Just simply by serving the spiritual master, then we can defeat the demon Madhu, and we can get rid of all material distress.
在对灵性导师的服务当中，我们能打败恶魔妈度，并且去除一切物质的苦难。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, we have Vidura speaking to his Shiksha Guru, Maitreya Muni. So by serving Maitreya, Vidura will get he'll be able to get service to Krishna. We can approach Krishna. We can't approach Krishna directly, but we can approach him by serving his pure devotees. Krishna, the Supreme Lord, is inconceivable, and he's unchanging. And we know Lord Krishna is famous for being offered mountains of food. And while standing on a special peak of Govardhan, that's what we offer Krishna a mountain of food, and Krishna stands on the Govardhan hill.
众所周知，主Krishna，人们供奉给主。当主Krishna站在特殊的高山山顶的时候，人们供奉给主 Krishna 像小山一样的食物。
The one who is a servant of the Vaishnavas, they can develop that love for Krishna. Material life is always full of miseries, but devotional service to Krishna helps us to get rid of all these miseries.
生活充满着种种苦难，但是对主 Krishna 奉献服务，可以去除这一切苦难。Devotion
destroys the pain felt by the conditioned soul.
受条件限制的灵魂。
Krishna's Rasa Leela is a festival for dancing, and dancing means you have to move the feet.
Krishna's Rasa Leela 就意味着跳Rasa之舞，跳Rasa之舞就意味着要移动脚步。
So if we join the Rasa Leela with Krishna, dance with Krishna and Rasa Leela, our feet will be, they won't feel the pain of the distress of the material world from doing other things. And Lord Kapila also tells his mother the same thing. Lord Kapila tells his mother that topics about Krishna heard in the association of devotees is very pleasing to the ear and to the heart. And Lord Kapila describes how we develop Krishna Prem. He says first we develop faith or Shraddha, and then we develop attachment for Krishna, and then we develop pure loving devotion.
Kapila 就描述了我们发展 Krishna Prem 对 Krishna 的爱的过程。首先是有信心 Shraddha， 接下来呢就培养起对 Krishna 的依恋，随后就逐步发展起对世尊主的纯粹的奉爱。
And when we do devotional service, these things they naturally become manifest without any extra endeavor.
当我们从事奉献服务的话，无需做额外的努力，这些就能自然而然地发展起来。
So, Lord Kapila, he wants us to understand that first, a new devotee should get faith, and then take up the process of bhakti by hearing, chanting, and serving.
就卡皮拉就讲述说，对一个新奉献者而言，首先呢，他必须拥有信心，随后呢，他就通过在奉献的联谊师下，他就通过聆听、唱诵、记忆这样的方法，逐步培养起奉爱之情。
And his attachment, his rati, the attachment which he has for Krishna, that will come later.
他对于 Krishna 的爱，依恋叫 rati， 这个是在随后才能到来的。
Bhakti, to do actual real bhakti means there has to be the practice of devotional service and also the spontaneous love.
真正的 bhakti 就意味着要去实践奉献服务，然后发展出自发的奉爱。
So that rati, that love for Krishna, that is the fruit of bhakti.
Krishna 的爱，这种 rati， 它是 bhakti 奉爱的果实。
So that in the same way, Dhruva Maharaj also prays to Lord Vishnu. He says to Lord Vishnu, "Please bless me so that I may associate with great devotees who engage in your service."
Dhruva Maharaj 也向主威士努献上祷文，他赞美了主威士努，他恳求威士努，请祝福我，让我能和伟大的奉献者们联谊，并且从事于服务。
Dhruva Maharaj said, "These devotees are always situated in the uncontaminated condition of life."
Dhruva Maharaj 说。这些奉献者处在没有受到污染的生命状态下。
And Dhruva Maharaj said, "If I also do devotional service, I'd be able to cross over the ocean of material existence."
Dhruva Maharaj 说，倘若我从事奉献服务，我也能够跨越物质存在的物质生存的海洋。
And Dhruva said, "It will be easy for me because I'm becoming anxious to hear about your qualities and pastimes."
Dhruva Maharaj 说，这样对我来说就变得容易了。倘若我渴望聆听，您的品质，您的逍遥时光。
Because devotees who are devotees of Vishnu.They will do set. They're always serving Krishna. Their service is very constant, so their hearts are completely pure.
Dhruva 说，主威士努的奉献者们，他们总是在服务 Krishna， 他们恒常的服务着 Krishna， 因此他们的内心是全然纯洁的。
So to get the association of that, this kind of devotees, this is what everybody wants, this is what we need. And we don't need anything else if we get that.
和这样的奉献者取得联谊是人人都渴望的，而且是人人都需要的，他们不需要别的。
We don't have to worry, oh, I should get liberation, I need to get liberation. No, but liberation comes automatically where there's pure devotion.
我们不应当担心，我要得到解脱呀，不，倘若我们得到了纯粹的供爱，就自动达到了解脱。Dhruva
Maharaj says, in the association of devotees, I'll drink the nectar of the topics of the Lord.
Dhruva Maharaj 说，在奉献者的联谊之下，我会喝饮主的话题的甘露。
Just like drunkards, their interest is in the taste of the alcohol. They're not really interested in the effects of the alcohol, but they like the taste.
就像那些醉汉们，他们就一心的想去品尝那个酒的滋味儿。
Just like some countries, they will drink alcohol because it's very cold. So when they drink the alcohol, their bodies will become warm.
就像在有的寒冷的国度，人们喝酒是为了使他们的身体变得暖和起来。So
in the same way, devotees who have a taste, they get a taste for drinking the nectar of Krishna Katha, they consider that relishing that nectar, that's the real goal.
同样的，那些就是津津有味于品尝Krishna Katha、Krishna话题的滋味的奉献者。
They don't think that the goal is to get liberation and they're just hearing to get liberation. They just take pleasure in hearing about Krishna.
他们并不想，他们的目标是解脱。
And Lord Shiva also explains, Lord Shiva says, if we get the association of a devotee, even by chance, even for a fraction of a moment, then we're no longer subject, we no longer get attracted to things like karma or jnana.
主Shiva也解释说，即便是偶然碰巧获得了跟奉献者的联谊，即便是片刻的联谊机会，也不会对于karma果报、果报或者jnana思辨，不会对他们有任何兴趣了。And
to get any benediction from the demigods is also no use because the demigods, they're under the laws of birth and death. So what benefit can they give us?
得到半神人的祝福也没有用处，因为半神人本身也是身处生死法则之下，所以得到他们的好处，得到他们祝福有什么好处？
But the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord is what is auspicious and it destroys all the contamination of the material world.
但是至尊主的莲花足是至为吉祥的，因为它能毁灭物质世界的污染。
So Lord Shiva prays that please bless me with the association of your devotees.
主 Shiva 就祈祷说, 请祝福我, 能得到你的奉献者们的联谊。
Because I know they're really pure. They worship your lotus feet. And they're so merciful upon the conditioned souls.
因为他们是至纯至粹的, 他们是崇拜着你的莲花族, 而且他们
So your real benediction to me will be allow me to associate with these devotees.
因此你对我真正的祝福就是允许我能够和这样的奉献者取得联谊。
So you see, Lord Shiva would prefer just a moment's association with these devotees.
So we can see from Lord Shiva's words, Lord Shiva would prefer to have a moment's association with
Because these devotees, they also have the company of the Supreme Lord. And the Supreme Lord dances on the heads of all the Supreme Lord. These pure devotees, they're always in the company of Lord Krishna. And by they have no interest in any other goal, like material goal, material success or power. It doesn't mean anything for them. They're so happy in the company of Krishna.
因为这样的纯粹奉献者，他们总是在主Krishna的陪伴之下，因此他们对于任何其他的目标都没兴趣。那些物质的目的啊，物质的成功啊。 所有物质的力量啊，对他们来说都没有丝毫的意义。他们在主Krishna的陪伴之下，感受到了时时刻刻感受到快乐。That
just by remembering the lotus feet of Lord Krishna removes all sin.
仅仅是通过意念着主Krishna的莲花足，就已经去除了一切的罪孽了。All
the holy places, including the river Ganga and the river Yamuna, where the gopis used to bathe, and all the holy places, they're all included within Krishna.
一切的圣地，包括恒河，还有牧牛姑娘沐浴的杨木那河，它们都包含在主。
So Lord Shiva, he takes two baths, one externally in the Ganga and the other internally in the Yamuna.
So Shiva, he is bathing twice. One is bathing in the outside, in the Ganga, and the other is in the inside, in the Yamuna River.
In the same way, a bath, if we bathe in Lord Krishna's fame purifies the devotees in two ways.
同样的,
Externally, we bathe by getting free from hellish punishment. The devotee won't be put into any punishment, hellish punishment.
外在的奉献者们，他们不会受到地狱的惩罚。
And the second thing, internally, they get cleansed by all their material desires in their heart are taken away.
代的奉献者们，他们内心的所有物质欲望都会被拿走。
So people, those devotees who are dedicated to Lord Krishna are always merciful to all others.
主 Krishna 的奉献者对所有其他的人都视为仁慈。
They have no lust, they have no contamination in their heart. They're very simple.And they have all good qualities.
他们没有色欲，他们内心也没有污染，他们内心淳朴，他们拥有一切美好的品质。
So Lord Shiva prays that Lord Vishnu's greatest mercy would on him would be to let him come in touch with Krishna's devotees.
主 Shiva 就祈祷说，主威士努的仁慈就是让他能够和他的奉献者们能够接触到他的奉献者们。
Then Jadbharat also in the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, Jadbharat is preaching to Maharaj Rahugana.
在圣典伯加瓦坛的第五篇当中呢 ，Jadbharat 也向国王 Rahugana 传教。
Maharaj Rahugana had asked him where he had gotten all of this attraction and love for the Supreme Lord, and Jadbharat said, "You only get it by taking the dust of the feet of great devotees."
然后呢，国王就问 Jadbharat， 他是如何发展起对至尊主的这种爱和吸引的呢 ？Jadbharat 回答说，只有去接受伟大奉献者莲花足下的尘土，才能够发展起对至尊主的爱和吸引。
We cannot understand the absolute truth just by practicing celibacy.Or just by following all the rules and regulations of household life. And we cannot understand the absolute truth by just by leaving home, becoming a vanaprastha, or by taking sannyas.Or by doing any kinds of austerities.
We also cannot understand the truth.
Just like in the winter time, some people may do austerity, they may keep themselves in the very ice cold water up to the neck for a long time.
在冬天呢，我们看到有些人，他们就把自己，浸泡在寒冷刺骨的河水当中，一直到他们的脖子那里。
And in the summertime, we may be surrounded by fire, and we sit under the hot sun, so that's a great austerity.
而在夏季的时候，有的人呢又坐在。又燃起一堆火，又让自己坐在这个火中间，暴晒在炎炎烈日之下，这无疑是一种苦行。
But these austerities will never help us to understand the absolute truth. You need to get the mercy of a great devotee.
但是这些苦行都无法帮助一个人去明白绝对真理。相反，他应该得到伟大奉献者的仁慈。
In the association of the pure devotees, they're not going to speak about politics or they're not going to speak about mundane subject matters.
在纯粹奉献者的联谊之下，他们是不会去谈论政治话题或者谈论世俗的话题。
the only topic they will discuss about are the qualities and the fame and pastimes of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
这些纯粹的奉献者只会谈论至尊主 Krishna 的品质、声望以及逍遥时光。
So by, if we constantly hear about Krishna, then even if someone wants to merge into the existence of the Supreme Lord, can gradually become attracted to the service of the to be with the devotees and attached to the service of Krishna, and to give up the idea of becoming one.
聆听主 Krishna 的话题，甚至一位想要融入至尊主 Krishna 存在的这样一个人，他也会被奉献服务所逐渐的吸引，也会想要得到奉献者的怜悯，从而放弃融入到 Krishna 的存在的想法。
So Jabbarat tells Maharaj Rahugan that to understand this Supreme Person is impossible to be done by any of the usual methods, like what we were saying, you know, austerities or being a perfect grihastha and all of these things. That's not going to help us to understand the Absolute Truth. You have to get the mercy of a devotee.
Jagbarat 告诉 Rahugana 国王，你要想明白至尊之人的话，通过一般的方法是不可能的，比如说，就苦行或者是完美的去旅行居士生活，这些都没有帮助，不能帮助一个人去理解绝对真理。唯一的方法就是得到奉献者们的仁慈。
It's not enough to just follow the duties of our varna and ashram and just to concentrate our mind and do tapasya. That's not enough.
仅仅是旅行在varna ashram四社会阶层灵性四阶段的职责是不够的，仅仅是苦行也不够。
May do Vedic sacrifices and give a lot of charity, do a lot of pious activities, it's not enough.
仅仅是做伟大的献祭，或者是布施，或者从事虔诚活动还不够。
These things, they may help us, by doing these kind of activities, it may help us to get the favor of Vasudeva. It may help us to get the favor of Krishna, only if the devotee has also pleased Krishna's devotees.
这些事物也许会有助于一个人得到Vasudeva，得到 Krishna 的恩宠，但是奉献者们应当去努力取悦。
If we satisfy the devotees, then you can get the mercy of Krishna.
倘若我们使奉献者们感到心满意足的话，就能得到主Krishna的仁慈了。Even
if we haven't done any of these other things, we haven't done any austerities, we haven't given any charity, we didn't follow our duties very good. But still, if we please the devotees, then Krishna, then we can develop our Krishna consciousness. We can get the mercy of Krishna.
即便我们没有做别的，没有去从事苦行，没有布施，也没有追随我们的职责，履行我们的职责，但仍然，倘若我们取悦了奉献者，Krishna的奉献者，也会发展起 Krishna 之觉，得到主 Krishna 的仁慈。
So one of Krishna's names is Uttama Sloka. it means he who's so famous, it takes away all the ignorance.
Krishna 有一个名字叫做 Uttama Sloka， 他意思就是说，他因为拿走了一切的愚昧而闻名遐迩。
So when we take the dust of the feet of the devotees, if we first take the dust of the feet of devotees, then we enter into the company, come and associate with the devotees, and hear from them about Krishna's qualities.
倘若我们接触到奉献者的莲花族的尘土的话，就能够进入到和奉献者们的联谊之下。在奉献者们的陪伴之下，去聆听有关于 Krishna 的品质。
So by hearing, if we hear regularly every day, then that Krishna Katha will help the materialist come up, and the materialist will think about liberation.
倘若我们有规律的每天聆听 Krishna Katha， Krishna 的话题。这个能帮助一个物质主义者晋升，使他想要获得解脱。
And he'll become eager for devotional service.
这样的物质主义者，他们就进而渴望得到奉献服务。
So Jadbharat said to Maharaj Rahugana.That the birth to take birth in the human body on earth is very great fortune. Even the demigods and the heavenly planets want that opportunity.
Jadbharat 就对 Rahugana 国王说，能够在地球上出生为人类是个巨大的好运，即便是天堂的半神人也都渴望得到这样的机会。
In the heavenly planets, they have a lot of material comfort, but they don't get the association with pure devotees.
在天堂呢，有大量的物质舒适的机会，但是呢，他们没有得到纯粹奉献者的联谊。
So human life is the best situation for coming to.Krishna consciousness.
因此，人类的出生是来到 Krishna 知觉当中的最好的处境。
The life of a demigod is not for intelligent people. That is just for foolish people.
半神人的生活，对于那些不。就只是给那些愚蠢的人的，一个有智慧的人不会渴望半神的生活。
Pure devotees like Jadbharat, they will hardly ever visit the heavenly planets.
像 Jadbharat 这样的纯粹奉献者，他们几乎不会去拜访天堂星球。
Because the demigods are so absorbed in sense gratification, they don't deserve to get the association of pure devotees.
因为半神人们他们都完全专注于感官享乐当中了，他们不配得到纯粹奉献者的联谊。
So the saintly devotees, the devotees will keep their hearts clean by always thinking about the glories of the Lord rather than thinking about the demigods.
奉献者们的内心，因为总是想着主的荣耀而得到了净化，他们想不起来半神人。
And they will go and visit the holy places on earth as well.
这些奉献者们也会去拜访地球上的圣地。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，那我们今天的讲课部分就到这里， 接下来我们来回答问题。第一个问题是，华为哈帕德说，我们应该骄傲于我们是 Krishna 的永恒仆人，如何在非奉献者中展示这种骄傲？So yeah, there are several question marks. So the first one is that Srila Prabhupada said we should be feel proud that we are eternal servant of Lord Krishna. So how can we exhibit this pride in front of non-devotees?
Well, we should understand that we're trying to become devotees. That we shouldn't think that I've already, that I'm a great devotee. Don't think that we're great devotees, but we're trying to become devotees.
要明白，我们正在努力成为奉献者，不要心里觉得我们都是伟大的奉献者。
And remember,
我们是在努力成做奉献者。
And we should remember what was our position before we became devotees.
而且我们不要忘记我们在成为奉献者之前我们自己的那番处境。
And this will keep us humble.
这就能让我们保持谦卑了。
And we should understand that whatever we are today is simply by the mercy of Krishna and the spiritual master Prabhupada's mercy.
我们也要明白，我们今天，我们之所以能达到今天的这样的地位，都是由于主 Krishna、Guru、Prabhupada 的仁慈。
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
The devotee said that isn't that it is required we are humble, we feel lower than Jagan Madai. How to make a pride and humble coordinate the feeling of pride and humble?
Yes, we should feel not proud, but we should feel fortunate. We should feel very fortunate somehow that we've been given the mercy.Of Krishna and his devotees.
我们的感受不是骄傲的感受，我们的感受是那种幸运的感受。我们觉得特别幸运，因为我们得到了主 Krishna 和奉献者们的仁慈。
So we offer all respects to others.
所以我们把所有的敬意我们把所有的敬意都给别人了。
And we
我们尊敬别人。
We don't want any respect for ourselves, but we want to offer respect to others.
我们不渴望别人来尊敬自己，相反我们是尊敬别人的。
And you have to constantly chant the holy name of Krishna.And preach Krishna consciousness.
而且您要恒常地唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名，还要向别人去传播。
That will keep you humble.
这样一来，您就会谦卑了。
Yes.
下一个问题来自于 Shruti Rupa Devdas. Four questions. Hare Krishna, 顶拜咕噜和老师们，儿童节快乐。有几个问题请教咕噜。一是关于 Parikshit 王的。既然他在母亲子宫当中就受到强大武器攻击，为什么后来仅仅因为口渴 仅仅因为口渴冒犯一位婆罗门而引发得到那么大诅咒呢？ Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru and all teachers, happy Children's Day. So the first question is that about Parikshit Maharaj. Since Parikshit Maharaj was attacked by the powerful weapon in his mother's womb, so why later, just because he feels thirsty and offended a Brahmana and he got cursed, got a big curse?
Yes, this was Krishna's arrangement for the speaking of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
是的，这个是主 Krishna 特意为了圣典薄伽瓦坛得以讲述而所做出的安排。
Sukadeva Goswami could come, and he could speak the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这样一来 ，Sukadeva Goswami 就可以来讲述圣典薄伽瓦坛了。
So you can understand that this was the arrangement of Lord Krishna.
所以你可以明白，这是主 Krishna 的安排。
It showed how the Brahmanas had become proud. It showed that it was the beginning of the decline of the Brahmins. They lost all their power and qualities because of their pride, thinking themselves better than others.
这也表明了，就是那些 Brahmana 他们是如何变得骄傲，他们就开始变得堕落，因为他们为自己的资格和力量感到骄傲，他们觉得自己要比别人强。
And then Krishna arranged for Maharaj Parikshit to sit down and hear Srimad Bhagavatam.And this speaking of the Srimad Bhagavatam, this was necessary for people in the Kali Yuga because Krishna had left the world. So the people who were in the world, they needed to have the shelter, who to take shelter of in the absence of Lord Krishna. So Krishna arranged for the speaking of Srimad Bhagavatam, and that isrepresentative of Krishna.
这个是一般就是主 Krishna 一般精心的安排，他就安排了 Parikshit 大军呢，就得到就趁此机会可以安安心心的坐下来聆听圣典薄伽瓦坛，的讲述，因为哈利年代已经即将开始了，而主 Krishna。他即将，主 Krishna 他离开了地球，所以就需要圣典薄伽瓦坛得以讲述，这样呢，世人就可以脱避于在主 Krishna 不在的情况下，脱避于圣典薄伽瓦坛，所以主 Krishna 就特意安排了圣典薄伽瓦坛被讲述，而且圣典薄伽瓦坛就是主 Krishna 的代表。
Okay.
The next question. 作为第二个，作为 Krishna 之节的出席者，我发现自己的服务非常粗糙造作，很多时候打着供奉 Krishna 的名义满足个人欲望。请问 Guru， 我如何能自发自动的满足 Krishna 的需求做服务呢？ The second one is that as the neophyte devotee of the Krishna consciousness, I felt my service is very gross and very artificial. Many times I'm doing the service to satisfy my personal desire in the name of Krishna. So Guru, how can I do my service spontaneously to satisfy Krishna's need?
Well, you have to You have to want to satisfy Krishna. You have to change that consciousness. You have to think that I'm doing this for Krishna. We have to just become more focused on Krishna and hear about Krishna and chant Krishna's name and develop our Krishna consciousness.
您得有这种想法，想去满足 Krishna， 您需要改变您的知觉，想着我是在为 Krishna 做这件事儿，要专注于 Krishna， 聆听 Krishna 的名，聆听 Krishna， 去唱诵 Krishna 名字，去发展 Krishna 知觉。
And Krishna makes arrangements to purify us, to help us to think of Him.
And Krishna will also arrange to purify us, to help us to think of Him.
Sometimes He will give us things to do which we don't like to do, but we have to do it for Krishna. Krishna is testing us every day. He's watching us to see how serious we are in our devotional service.
Krishna 每天都在给我们考试。
So, you have to be determined and you have to be patient and you have to keep bringing the mind back away from the body and bringing to Krishna, thinking of Krishna.
所以你就要下定决心，还要有耐心，你要把心意呢从 关注躯体，转移到专注于 Krishna 身上。第三个问题，还有一个普遍现象，很多初学者习惯把过去的经历与Krishna知觉做对比，就是在比较哪边吸引力大，就靠近哪边。请问Guru，我们在联谊聚会时候，除了阅读圣典、唱歌、荣耀， 跳舞、荣耀、不杀等，还应该从哪些方面关心新人，鼓励他们稳定在 Krishna 之觉中进步呢？ There's another popular situation that many newfies they like to compare their past experience with Krishna consciousness to see which side is more attractive. They will go. So, Guru, during the association, except reading scripture, chanting, dancing, and honor prasadam, in which way should we take care of those new devotees and encourage them to stay very steadily in Krishna consciousness and make progress?
Well, every individual has to develop their own taste for Krishna consciousness.
每一个人都应该发展出他们自己独一无二的对 Krishna 知觉的品味。
Everyone is an individual, and we all have our own individual likes and dislikes.
We have to
just simply depend on Krishna, that Krishna's in everyone's heart. And if Krishna wants this person to become a devotee, Krishna will certainly help them and inspire them.
We just need to rely on Krishna, because Krishna is in the heart of Krishna 就会去帮助这个人，而且在内心来激励他。
At the same time, we want to keep friendly relationships with everyone and do our best to try to help them and encourage them.
与此同时，我们应该跟每个人都处于都建立一种友好的关系，然后尽最大的努力去帮助他们，去鼓励他们。
But somebody who is coming into Krishna consciousness, they have to feel that this Krishna consciousness is certainly much more important than anything in the material world.
但是，倘若人们进入到 Krishna 知觉当中，他们应该有这种感受，就是 Krishna 知觉比物质世界的任何其他事情都更重要。
There's the material world, whatever we're doing in the material world, that is all karma. That is due to our karma, we're placed in these situations, and it'sfull of a lot of difficulties, a lot of struggles, and a lot of problems and anxiety.
在物质世界当中的一切呢，都是由于 karma, 由于因果，才使得一个人，他在自己的这种处境之下，而且呢，物质世界呢是充满着麻烦、困难。挣扎问题焦头烂额。
Of course, we could say, well, in devotional service, there's also some anxiety, there's also some problems, but it's not like the material world. These, whatever we experience in the spiritual world, in Krishna consciousness, whatever anxiety we experience in Krishna's service, that is giving us ecstasy.Bringing ecstasy.
然而在奉献服务当中的焦虑和在奉献服务当中遇到的问题，可跟物质世界的焦虑、物质世界的问题是截然不同的。在奉献在 Krishna 知觉当中的焦虑，它是会带来狂喜的。
So devotee they have to experience the taste, the higher taste of Krishna consciousness, and only then they can actually be fixed and convinced of devotional service.
所以，奉献者们他们必须自己有第一手的亲身的对于 Krishna 知觉的亲身的这种品味高，就是。只有当他们觉得 Krishna 知觉他们品尝到 Krishna 知觉的这种高级的品味的时候，他们才会有信心，对奉献服务充满着坚定的信心。
And they should also be, they should be disappointed about the material world. They should have understood that the material world is just so full of many problems and so much unpleasant situations in material life.
他们也要对物质世界，失望。他们应该看透了物质世界。到处都是问题，而且在物质世界，物质生活是非常令人不愉快的。
And they should be looking for the alternative to the material life. They should be looking for a solution, a way out of their material problems.
他们应当是渴望着、寻找着物质生活的一种替代品。他们应该是渴望着去，处理所有这些，物质世界的这些问题，来解决这些问题。
So they should not be too much attached to the material world.
他们应当是对于物质世界没有那么多的依附。
OK。
好，第四个问题。目前很多奉献者都在接受国家福利免费接种疫苗，有些人想请咕噜开示，如何把物质躯体受物质属性影响转化成灵性进步。So the fourth question is that many devotees are injecting this vaccine of COVID-19 under the benediction of the country for free. Some new fighters want guru to reveal to them how can we change the situation that this material body is under the influence of material mode. So how can we change it into, transform it into spiritual progress? Thank you, Guru.
We can transform the material body to the spiritual body by devotional service. The more we are absorbed in Krishna consciousness, then our body will become surcharged with spiritual energy.
We can, through volunteer service, transform the material body into a spiritual body. We can, through focusing on volunteer service, make our body be filled with spiritual energy.
Just like you put the metal bar into the fire, the metal bar takes on all the qualities of the fire, heat and light. Not immediately, but you have to leave the bar in the fire. It takes some time, but gradually the metal bar becomes like fire.
打个比方，就好像我们把一根金属棒放到火中，那么这根金属棒呢，它就会拥有这个火的品质，它拥有热量，它有光，会发光，但不是立刻就会有这些品质的。你必须得把这根火棒、金属棒，把它留在火中，然后花过一段时间，它逐渐的就会拥有这根金属棒，就会像火一样拥有火的品质了。
So
our body is, we have a material body, we have a gross physical body, we have a subtle body, we have also a spiritual body.
我们现在是拥有物质的躯体，我们有粗糙的躯体，还有精微的躯体，但是我们还有灵性的躯体。
So, if we use our body, mind and words all in the service of Krishna, then the gross body and the subtle body will become spiritualized in contact with Krishna.
We should use our body, 心意、话语来服务 Krishna. 这样呢，在跟 Krishna 的联谊当中，我们的粗糙躯体、精微躯体就能灵性化。
Okay.
下一个问题，华为还是把纯粹奉献者莲花足下的尘土放在头上，能得到对 Krishna 的爱？这句话什么含义？我已经把很多咕噜足下的尘土，把很多我周围进入奉献的如下尘土放在头上，怎么还没得到 Krishna 慈爱呢？哪里出毛病了呢？ So this question is raised by the same devotee who raised the first question. He said that I have what's the meaning that we should put the dust from the lotus feet of pure devotee, put it in on our head, therefore we can get love, Krishna prema. So what does this sentence mean? Because I have put many dust from the lotus feet of Guru and also the dust of many advanced devotees, their lotus feet, the dust from their lotus feet on my head. So why I haven't developed the pure love for Krishna? What's wrong? Where is the wrong?
Well, just like people come and they take bath in the Ganga, they come and bathe in the Ganges and they get purified, but then they go away and they do all bad things again.
就像人们来了，他们就去恒河当中沐浴，然后他们得到了净化，然后他们又走了，走了之后他们又去做坏事。They
don't give up. They don't stop their bad habits. They don't change.
他们不放弃这些坏事，他们没有改掉他们的坏习性，他们没有做出改变。
So the devotee, you may take the dust from the devotee's feet and you put it on your head, but if you continue to act like a fool, if you continue to do nonsense things, then you're not taking advantage of the dust.
同样的，您可能已经把他们足下的尘土呢放在您的头上，但是如果您继续的胡作非为、做蠢事儿，那么你就没有充分的利用这些尘土。The
devotees are giving you mercy, but you're not taking advantage. You're continuing all your nonsense.
奉献者们，他们都纷纷的给您仁慈，但是呢，您没有善加利用，您还继续胡作非为。So
you have to also want to take advantage of the dust. That means to stop all your nonsense and just to surrender fully to devotional service.
所以您应当也想要善加利用这些莲花族的尘土，这个意思就是说，您要停止那些不好的事儿，胡作非为，然后全然的臣服于奉献服务。You
should be ready to give up everything for the service of the devotee.
您呢，准备好。 为了服务贡献者，放弃一切。
You're taking the dust from the feet, you should surrender to them, give up everything and become their servant.
您已经得到了他们足下的尘土，您当臣服，然后放弃一切，就做他们的仆人。
Just like we're chanting the holy name. We're chanting the holy name, we're asking Krishna, please engage me in your service. But when we get the chance to do devotional service, we don't want to do it.
这就好像我们唱诵圣名，然后我们祈求恳求Krishna让我们从事对他的服务，然后等机会来的时候呢，我们却不去做服务。
We expect Krishna to do everything for us. We have to reciprocate with Krishna. We have to want to take Krishna's mercy. It's not just that we pray to Krishna and Krishna will do everything. We have to also cooperate with Krishna's plan.
这就好像是我们期望着，我们指望着Krishna给我们做一切事情。 我们是应当要想要回报Krishna，我们应当去想要接受Krishna的仁慈，而不是说祈祷Krishna来把我们都为我们做好了每一件事，面面俱到都做好了。我们应当是渴望着去跟 Krishna 合作，去执行 Krishna 的计划。
So you get the dust, the devotee gives you the dust. That's a chance for you to progress. then it's up to you. You have free will. It's not that just you get the dust and it all happens on its own. You have to want to take advantage of the dust of the feet of the devotee.
那您得到奉献者们他们莲花族的尘土，这是您取得进步的一个良机。所以呢，接下来就取决于你了。因为你有自由意志，你不能想着哦，我已经得到了这些尘土，那么一切都会自动的发生。不是的，您当想着要怎么利用他们莲花族的尘土。
We take the dust from the feet of the devotee, and then we don't chant, and we don't wake up in the morning and do sadhana. We think, oh, what happened? The dust of the devotee didn't help me. It's up to us. We have that free will.
我们想得到他们莲花族的尘土，然后呢，我们又不念诵，然后我们清晨也不早起。 我们也不去做规范修行萨德呢，然后我们就想着，哦，我得到这些尘土，怎么没用啊？他们没有得帮助我，不是的，因为你有您的自由意志，一切呢就取决于您了，接下来的。So
we have to learn how to take advantage of the mercy of the devotee.
所以我们要学习的功课就是怎么去善加利用奉献者们的仁慈。That
is to be very enthusiastic and eager for devotional service.
那就是应当满腔热情的，热切渴望奉献服务。Okay. 下一个，顶拜老师，由于因果报应，我所在城市没有奉献者，家庭限制，又无法发展本地奉献者，无法出门，只能在网上听课联谊，无法面对面联谊。在这种情况下，渴望被提议，需要做什么吗？谢谢。So this question maybe is raised on behalf of another devotee. Obeisant school teacher, because of my karma, there are no devotees in the local city, and because of the restriction of the family, so I cannot develop the local devotees. Also, I cannot go out of the door. I can only listen online and get online association. I cannot get factual association. Under such circumstances, I aspire to be initiated. What do I do? Thank you.
Well, you have to be patient in that situation. You have to be patient. You have to continue hearing and listening online and associating with devotees online. Everything you can do on your own at home, you're able to read and chant, and you're able to offer your food at home. So that's good.
您继续就在网上听课，然后在网上联谊，然后其他的就是您自己要去读书、念诵、供奉食物，这很好。So
gradually you can develop a relationship with devotees, and they can guide you to approach a spiritual master.
这样呢？ 就逐步发展起跟奉献者们发展起一种关系，他们就能帮助你去接近灵性导师。Yeah,
we know it's not everyone's able to get so much freedom. you don't have a lot of freedom. Maybe as you get older, maybe your situation will change.
因为不是人人都有那么大的自由，那是等您老了，上年纪以后，您的处境可能会发生改变。
Life in the material world is temporary.
物质世界的生活是短暂的。
And there's always things changing, things change a lot. So, you know, your situation can also change gradually.
所以呢，事情都在翻天覆地的发生变化，所以您的处境也会变化的。
But you are very fortunate to hear about Krishna and to start chanting and to this is devotional service. Your devotional service has begun, so you're very lucky.
您非常幸运，因为您可以聆听 Krishna 念诵圣名，从事奉献服务。您的奉献服务已经开始了，所以您很幸运。
And you can contact devotees through mobile networks. You can contact them and make some friendship with a devotee.
您可以接触奉献者们，通过手机的网络呢，跟奉献者们交朋友。
And definitely you can make advancement.
您肯定能取得进步的。
The
next one. Yeah. Radha Chaitanya Charan. Hare Krishna, Bhai Gurudev. 感谢您。夜报瑜伽有哪几个层次？都有夜报吗？ 夜报瑜伽里有奉爱瑜伽活动吗？ 夜报瑜伽。 Hare Krishna, Business Gurudev. How many levels are there in the karma yoga? Are there karma in karma yoga? So there are several also.
Okay. How many levels are there in karma yoga? Generally, we speak of two levels in karma yoga. We say sakam karma yoga and niskam karma yoga. Sakam karma yoga means karma yoga done with attachment to the results. And niskam karma yoga means karma yoga done without attachment to the results, to the fruit of the work.
夜报瑜伽有两个层次，一个层次叫 Sakam Karma Yoga， 另外一个叫 Nishkam Karma Yoga。 第一个 Sakam Karma Yoga 就是依附活动的结果，然后第二个层次 Nishkam Karma Yoga 是不依附工作的结果。
So, karma yoga means to perform our duty. We're attached to working in a particular way, but we do that work as an offering to Krishna.
Karma yoga 就是活动瑜伽，就是履行我们的职责，而且是依赖于以特定的活动方式。 依赖于以特定的方式来从事活动，但是是为了Krishna来从事这样活动的。So
Sakama Karma Yoga, he may give some very small percentage of the fruit of his work, or he may not even give anything. He may just say, only I'm working for Krishna, but I need the fruit, I can't give anything. Or sometimes they may give 1% or 2%.
Sakam Yoga， 这样的人呢，他们可能会拿出 一部分的工作成果献出来，或者是他们根本就不拿出来，他们有可能说啊，我是为 Krishna 在做这个工作，但是我自己我也需要啊，我也需要这个工作结果，所以我拿不出来。所以他们可能会拿出1%，甚至2%的工作结果供出来。
And Nishkam Karma Yoga, one is attached to working also, does his duty, and he gives nearly all of the fruit, or he may give 100%, or he may give a lot, a big percentage of the fruit of his work.
而下面一个层次 ，Nishkam Karma Yoga 就是不带欲望的从事，不带欲望的从事于业报活动。他们依附于工作，依附于各地固定的职责，但是呢，他们把100%的活动结果都供出来，或者是他们把大部分工作结果都供出来了。
Now sometimes we do see that the Mayavadi impersonalists they also do karma yoga.
有时候我们见到有些假象宗主义者那些。非人格主义者，他们也从事着，karma yoga 就是活动瑜伽，行动瑜伽。
So not only devotees are doing karma yoga, you may find also mayavadis are doing karma yoga.
所以，从事于行动瑜伽的不仅仅有奉献者，也有假象宗人士。
Then he asks, "Do I get karma? Is there karma in doing karma yoga?" Well, if you're doing karma yoga, there's no karma. If you're doing karma yoga, but you have to give the fruit, you have to give all the fruit for Krishna.
第二个问题，在从事于行动瑜伽当中有没有业报反应呢？答案是没有，但是前提是你必须100%的把你的活动结果都供奉出来。就没有业报了。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was worried about sinful reactions from fighting in the battle. So Krishna told him, if you fight as karma yoga, then there's no sinful reactions.
就像在国家梵歌当中， Arjuna 担心作战会招致罪恶反应，但是 Krishna 向 Arjuna 保证，如果他从事的是行动瑜伽。就不会招致罪恶反应。
And the last part, what's his other question?
业报瑜伽里有奉爱瑜伽活动吗？Are there any bhakti yoga activity of bhakti yoga in karma yoga? Karma yoga.
Yes. Well.Bhakti yoga is what? Hearing and chanting and serving Krishna. Just like you can be serving Krishna, you're cooking for Krishna is bhakti yoga. But some people, their cooking may be karma yoga.
是的，就像我们
业
报瑜伽里有奉爱瑜伽的活动，奉爱瑜伽就是聆听、唱诵、服务 Krishna， 为 Krishna 做饭。这个是 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽。您在为 Krishna 做饭，所以您这个就是在做的是 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽。有的人他们也做饭，但是他们是从事的是 Karma Yoga， 是业活动瑜伽。
Yeah, it may be their job. You know, they're working.Their job is cook, right? So they do it. They do the job. It's my job. I'm a cook, you know, and a cook. And they may say, I'm cooking for Krishna.
就好像有的人他的工作就是厨师，这是他的工作。他们也可能说，我在为 Krishna 在做这个工作。
But they're cooking more out of a sense of duty rather than out of love.
但是他们是出于值得感在作伴，而不是出于爱心在作伴。
So the difference is there in consciousness, you see. Somebody is doing the job, they're doing their cooking as a service for Krishna, and somebody is just doing it as my duty. They need a job, they need some money, they have a family, they need money to maintain their families and so on. So they get paid, but you know, they're cooking for Krishna. Now they may be devotees, but still they're attached to some result of the work. So that's karma yoga. But devotional service, a devotee understands everything is Krishna's. Just like giving charity, one may think this is all Krishna. A devotee will give because he said it's all Krishna. So I'm just giving Krishna, it's his money. I'm giving back, it's not my money, it's Krishna's money. But somebody else thinks, I'm giving, this money was mine and I'm giving to Krishna. So that's like karma yoga.
Karma yoga, 我动瑜伽。
问题都回答了吗？
没有。Is the karma yoga is it equal as Buddha yoga? 业报瑜伽算不算智慧瑜伽？
Karma yoga is equal to Yebao Yuja.
Is it karma yoga counted as Buddha yoga?
Buddha yoga, yeah. Yeah, Buddha yoga is Niskam karma yoga. Buddha yoga is the top level of karma yoga, done detached work without attachment to the fruit.
This devotee is paying obeisance to Guru, and this devotee asks, can we select the object of our association, the person who we associate? Some devotees we don't like, we dislike some devotee. Can we keep some distance with this kind of devotee so that they don't disturb our mind?
Yes, you can do that.
可以远离那些我们不喜欢的奉献者，可以选择我们联谊对象，以免打扰心意。 next part. 听帕帕德讲课说，要实现 Krishna 的愿望才是灵性能解脱，实现自己的愿望是物质的，受束缚。问题是目前做不到，还说不期待别人尊敬自己，目前做不到怎么办？ Srila Prabhupada said in his lecture that, if we fulfill the desire of Krishna, that is spiritual, that can bring liberation.And if we fulfill our own desire, it is material. It will bring bondage. But the problem is that we cannot do that, allow that. And it is also that said that we don't expect respect from that others. We cannot fulfill, we cannot do that also. What to do? The first is that Srila Prabhupada said that fulfillKrishna's desire is spiritual, fulfill our own desire is material. One brings liberation, the other brings bondage.
Yeah.
The problem is we cannot do that. What to do?
If we cannot do that, we cannot think of Krishna.
We cannot, maybe the consciousness, we cannot.Change our consciousness to fulfill Krishna's desire.
Well, we have to do what you can do. You have to understand what you are able to do for Krishna, and you have to do that.
我们要看一下我们能做什么，我们能为 Krishna 做什么，我们就做那个我们能做的。
At least you have to follow four principles. You have to chant 16 rounds. You may not have the same desire as Krishna. You may not desire to awaken Krishna consciousness in everyone. But you have to know what do you want to do for Krishna. You have to do something for Krishna. You have desire. You have to make sure your desire should be in line with Krishna. It shouldn't be opposed to Krishna.
您都有自己的愿望，但是你的愿望呢，必须是跟 Krishna 一致的，而不是反对跟 Krishna 愿望背道而驰的。
Well, Krishna is very accommodating. Krishna allows everyone to engage in devotional service. So what you have to decide, what are you going to do? What do you want to do? What is your desire? You say you must have some desire. So your desire has to be purified. It has to be somehow connected to Krishna.
Krishna 他是特别包容的，他允许每一个人从事服务，然后接下来就是你自己要决定你想做什么，但是你的愿望呢，必须是净化的愿望，必须是跟 Krishna 有关系的愿望。And it's also said that we don't expect respect from others, but we cannot do that. What to do?
We don't expect respect. We should not expect respect from others, but we do expect respect from others. That's because we're not Krishna conscious, because we've not purified our consciousness yet.
我们现在还在期待别人的尊敬， 这说明我们没有 Krishna 知觉，我们应当净化我们的知觉。
Because you're still in the bodily conception of life, so you have that consciousness. So you have to gradually purify that bodily consciousness by hearing and chanting.
您还就是一个人，当一个人他仍然渴望别人尊敬的话，这说明这个人他还在躯体化的概念下，这是他的知觉，他要净化他的躯体化生命概念。他应该通过聆听唱诵来净化这种物质的躯体化概念。
Yes.
那下一个灵慧，深深顶拜尼什纳古鲁，谢谢您。古鲁今儿早上讲，得到纯粹奉献者联谊仁慈祝福，能不能请古鲁给我您的仁慈祝福？疫情过后，您来我们中国，以后来中国的灵性，以后疫情过后您来我们中国和以后来中国的灵性导师服务的机会。Hare Krishna. This devotee paid deep obeisance to you, and this morning in the lecture you mentioned many times about to get the mercy and benediction from pure devotee.And get their association. So, and this devotee asked, "Can you give her your mercy and benediction after this COVID-19? You come to China, and also give us chance to serve the spiritual other spiritual masters to serve them, Hare Krishna."
Yes, we bless you. We benedict you to serve the devotees when they all come to China again.
Guru, 他祝福您，然后等那个疫情结束之后，能够服务奉献者，能够服务那些来到中国，再次来到光临我们中国的奉献者们。
And may you always stay in Krishna consciousness.
也祝福你永远的。留在 Krishna 这些当中。
Okay.
The last one, S.E. 前进顶拜咕噜莲花族，怎样理解莲花族尘土？是足上沾的土吗？怎样得到感恩咕噜？So this devotee paid obeisance to your lotus feet, and how to understand the literal meaning, the meaning, how to understand.Dust from the lotus feet. Is it the real dust on the feet? How to get that dust? Thank you, Guru.
Well, you can take it literally, and you can also take it in another sense, that the dust of the lotus feet implies we should give service to the Guru.
你可以从字面上理解，就是得到这个土，这个意思就是得到服务咕噜的机会。
That is more powerful dust if you do service for the devotees.
如果能得到服务奉献者的机会，这是更加有力量的尘土。
If you serve Srila Prabhupada's mission.Distribute Srila Prabhupada's books, that is how you will get the dust of the feet of Srila Prabhupada.
如果您服务 Srila Prabhupada 的使命去派书，那么这就是得到 Srila Prabhupada 莲花族上的尘土的，这就是得到了 Srila Prabhupada 莲花族的尘土了。
Yes.Okay, thank you very much, Guruman.
Thank you very much.
Waman Ganshi, Fichan Ganshi, Gurumani, Waman Jintai Dufani, Waman Ganshi, Ganshi, Amy, Juja, Ganshi, Soyo, the Function, Ling Ting, and Tiwan, Waman Juhuniman, Shanghai Kuala, Wanshi Rui, Chuan Jiao, Shun Li, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Krishna.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Ganguru. 非常感谢。
感谢 Amy. Hare Krishna.